Hi, this is Jaya. Now we shall see the summary of The Death Trap by Saki. Now the Death Trap is actually a very, very interesting one-act play written by Saki. His real name is H.H. Munro. That is Hector Hugh Munro. And he is a very witty British author. And he always wrote either in the name of Saki or as H.H. Munro. And he is compared to O. Henry and Dorothy Parker and E.F. Benson because his standard is so great. Munro was actually born in Burma. But when he was 2 years old, his mother died and so he was brought back to England. And he died in France during the World War I because a German sniper fired accidentally on him. And this is a very famous quote by him, which were his last words. When he died, before he could die, he said, "Put that bloody cigarette out." So these were his last words in this world. And he is very famous for his The Open Window story also, which I'll do another video on it. And this one act play is actually about how people, three of generals, they plan a conspiracy against their prince Dmitri. And this prince Dmitri is the prince of Kedaria. And at the same time, how this Dmitri takes his revenge on them. And it is a very, very interesting story. The story goes like this. Prince Dmitri, he has got his a rival called as Prince Karel. This Prince Karel wants to become the king. But Prince Dmitri became the ruler in a very young age itself. And so Karel thinks that if he murders Prince Dmitri, he can become the king. Now, three military regiments, namely Andreev Regiment, Lonyardy Regiment and Kranitz Regiment, they guard Prince Dmitri. And so Prince Karel is not able to do anything to him. Not only that, there is a physician. Physician means a doctor. Dr. Stronitz. And he is very loyal to this Prince Dmitri. And the Kranitz regiment is very loyal to the enemy, and in that there are three officers, Colonel Girnitzer, Major Wontef and Captain Schelt. They also plan to murder Prince Dmitri because they think that if they help him and if they murder this prince, then they will be getting their promotions. And so what happens is they want to help Prince Karel, and they are not worried about being disloyal to Prince Dmitri, but they are only bothered about their own promotions and what favors they can get from Prince Karel. Now when the play opens, we come to know about all this from the way three guards are talking. And the three guards, they are saying that these people are planning to kill Prince Dmitri once the guards of Kranitzegi regiment move away. And they say that as soon as Prince Dmitri is assassinated, Prince Karel will become the king. And they know that surely this will take place. And from their speech, we understand that Prince Dmitri also knows that his life is in danger and all those around him are planning to kill them. But even then, everyone is prepared to go ahead and kill him. And at the same time, inside in his room, Prince Dmitri is talking with his physician, Dr. Stronitz. And Dr. Stronitz, from their speech, we come to understand that Prince Dmitri has become the ruler at a very young age. And when he was so very young, he was totally helpless. So all these people around him only had to help him in ruling the government. And this helplessness itself has made others to take advantage of him. So now he is not in a position to command against these people because they were the actual people who were helping him earlier. And Prince Dmitri understands he is being trapped because all his weapons are taken away, people who are around him are being sent out slowly, and he knows that very well he will also be killed as soon as his Loyal Antrim regiment leaves. And what happens is, now Dr. Stonitz, he feels very sad for him because he is not a warrior and he cannot even fight with the other people. But he has a plan. So he tells Prince to remove his dress. And he says, I'll just examine you as though I am examining, but it is a fake examination. And I'll fool others. I'll fool the people who are disloyal to you. I'll tell them that you are suffering from a severe sickness and you are going to die within a few days. So this will at least delay them from murdering you right now. It will save you for a few days. But the prince says, it will save me for a few days, but anyway they are going to murder me after that. No. So how will this help? But he says, the doctor says, at least something will happen within the day. So we'll do that for now. And the prince also accepts it. So he doesn't know what to do. He thinks, okay, if we delay them from murdering me, maybe I'll devise another plan to escape from them. But when the physician is examining only, he understands that this prince is really having a heart disease which is incurable. And then afterwards, the physician tells everyone, the prince is suffering from a disease and he is going to die in a few days. And the prince also has decided already that he will commit suicide then to die in the hands of this disloyal guards. But Dr. Stones, he says, no. This is not correct. I know you are suffering from a heart disease, you are going to die. But what is the use? But he says, no, I don't want these people to murder me and die. So you please help me, give me poison. So Dr. Strawn says, okay, I'll give you poison and you can die. You will die on your own. They will not get the chance to kill you. And he gives him the poison. But at that time, Prince Dmitri gets an idea. He says, I am anyway going to die. Whether I am consuming poison and dying or not, my heart disease is going to kill me. But I will take revenge on my enemies and then only kill myself. So he mixes the full poison in a bottle of wine and he calls all the three officers who are disloyal to them and he says, the doctor has said I am going to die in a few days. So I want to thank you people for helping me from my childhood to rule the government. And he says, come, we'll have the drink. And they also think, okay, anyway, he's going to die on his own. So why should we go and kill him? His disease is going to kill them. And in their happiness that Prince Carlo is going to become the ruler and they are going to get lots of favor from him, they drink the wine and they all die. And thus the play ends. And this is the reason why Sakhi has kept the title as the Death Trap, which is the prince is giving a trap for them. And those three have trapped the prince already so that they can murder him. Beautiful revenge story in a one-act play. I hope you've liked the video. Share it with your friends. Like the video. And if you've not subscribed my channel, please subscribe. Thank you.